My name is Kelly Klima, and I'm a research scientist in engineering and public policy at Carnegie Mellon University. My work and my team's work focuses on natural hazards and the related urban adaptation, which is to say how you help cities and communities prepare themselves against the effects of a changing climate. One example of research we've been doing recently is looking how to prepare against heat wave events. In cities and communities, you have things called the urban heat island effect, which makes temperatures slightly warmer than the rural surroundings. If you add that to heat wave events and climate change further exacerbating the problem, you can have a lot of illnesses and deaths due to the heat. What my team has been looking at is stepping through 3 points of how you reduce the risk for the heat-related events. So first, where are the temperatures the hottest? Using satellite data and sensors, you know, what areas of town are naturally hotter than others? Second, where do the vulnerable people live? Where are the elderly? Where are the children? Where are the people who are, say, taking medications that don't interact well with heat? You can combine these together and understand, where should I put in solutions for my city or community to reduce this risk? To help prepare, we can do 2 things. First is to combat climate change directly through reducing greenhouse gas emissions. And a lot of cities and countries throughout the world are working really hard on this. The second thing is to help them understand how to prepare for the effects of a changing climate. And that can include things like putting up dams, seawalls, or levees, or things like improving green infrastructure, which will both have heat effects as well as water effects, or doing things like optimal placing of cooling centers. All of these things combined, both the greenhouse gas reductions and the adaptation, will help cities and communities prepare in the future for the effects of changing climate.